I'm here an employee at the Neutech Park, the facility we are in at the moment, and I will give you a talk to share some experience we made in the introduction of free software in our region. I took as example the sector of tourism. Is it okay with the audio? Yes. The sector for tourism, and I will explain you free software and open standards use in tourism here in South Tyrol. So how did we get companies and organizations understanding better what free software brings to the region? So we had to fulfill four steps in our view. The first step is to create a common vision among all the stakeholders, which are not technical, often. The decision makers don't have an understanding of digital technologies, but they have other goals, other drivers. And therefore, step two was important to understand what are their challenges, what are the challenges they are facing in their field. So if we talk about tourism, a step to bring them to understand the benefits of using open standards for afterwards introducing them to a free software architecture and platform. Bonus input from my side is how do you provide an infrastructure to manage this transformation process? Because it's a transformation process you are implementing in your region. So first of all, the common vision. What is a common vision everybody understands? So we had to start from the understanding, from the priorities of the region itself. So one of our priorities is sustainability. When we talk about digital technologies, nobody in South Tyrol wants to create a smart city, hyper-technological cities, but we want to preserve our landscape. This is the capital we have, the asset we are using, especially in tourism. So therefore, the common vision we developed is smart green region, meaning that we use technology to understand our nature better and to preserve our nature. If we understand, we see that our nature has a problem, we can make a strategy with actions to help the nature staying green as it is today. Okay, then after the vision, step two was understand the challenges the tourism organizations are facing. What are their pains at the moment? Or what are they afraid of? So, Alexa. They are afraid by Alexa. 3 years ago on the German market, Amazon started to sell Alexa. So a lot of guests coming in to South Tyrol come from the German market. And these guests started to not call our tourism organizations anymore or look at our tourism organization websites for information. They just ask Alexa, where should I go for skiing this weekend? And if Alexa has not good data, and if Alexa doesn't know that we have snow and that we have an offering and it's open, Alexa will suggest some other place. So how can we create an infrastructure that Alexa has high quality data and good data from first hand? That was a very important question. And it's not just Alexa, because if it would be just Alexa, you can maybe make a contract with Amazon. Pay Amazon to do it. But there are a lot of these new technologies coming up. Mercedes has a windshield, an intelligent windshield, which understands if you are tired. And if you are tired, it suggests a place to go for the night. And you can book from Mercedes. So how can you interact with every Mercedes car with this system and provide the right data? That's a question. And what will happen when autonomous vehicles will reach South Tyrol? Will they stop? Will they know that we have offerings? Or will they just pass through South Tyrol? And the next step, I don't know if you know this project, Neuralink by Elon Musk. So he wants to connect our brains directly with the internet. That means we will just have to think about skiing and know where snow is. At least we know where the information from the internet is. So on the base of the information, the link to the internet will get. So you have no apps in the future, no internet websites, nothing. It's just data coming directly from the internet. Okay, so how did we do, how did we accomplish that companies start to work together? That was the first step. So you have, we have a lot of companies creating digital products for tourism in South Tyrol, and we got them on the table. And at the moment we have an alliance, which is called Alpine Beats Alliance, where we have many companies. Some companies specialized in creating PMS, which are hotel management software. Some companies creating portals, tourist portals, booking system, and the others. And we get them together to create a community of companies and organizations to define an open standard to exchange data, tourism data. So availabilities, prices in real time. They can exchange this data among them other. And this was the first step. Companies understood if we are working together, we create one documentation together, we reduce our cost to define the APIs. And the next step, step four, was then, okay, we want to that they understand the benefits of free software. We create a free software architecture where everybody can participate. And so we created a layer called Open Data Hub, which is a project we are managing, where we are helping organizations and companies in different sectors to open up their data. And we do it as a big free software project where we involve all these players. The team behind the project itself is a very small team. It's 7 people in total, which are coordinating at the moment around 60 companies in South Tyrol and a little bit abroad of South Tyrol, and 150 developers, project managers, and designers are involved. And so it has become a big community project where every company involved understands the benefit to work on an open source free software platform. So leading by creating an infrastructure to involve all these people to solve, on the other hand, the big challenges of an economical sector. What was very important for us was to create an infrastructure which is able to handle this collaboration. So if you open up and you have 60 companies working for your project, it gets really difficult to maintain the processes clear. And the first thing was to completely automate as much as possible in the development process. So we force every company to produce and to give us the source code directly, which is then automatically by our systems compiled and deployed on testing machines, testing environment, and production environment. This is a crucial thing, because otherwise you get source code and some binaries, but you never know if they are of the same branch or not. So you have to do the work and automate the work of the whole compiling and distribution. And you have to provide this infrastructure as an open infrastructure, as open source, so the developer company can clone it into their own company for their development process they are using. And the next thing we had to introduce, which was very important, was to have clear requirements in the procurement. When we work with external companies, a requirement is that they use open standards. They cannot give us data or connect to the Open Data Hub project if an open standard exists for this kind of data. If there is data, nobody has created an open standard yet, of course we have to be creative. But if there is an open standard like Alpine Beats, they have to use Alpine Beats to provide us the data. The next very important and difficult step was to have an agreement that all data created will be provided as open data. So this is a very complicated step. I'm looking at the photographer and the cameraman. Now think about a hotel who gets some pictures, buys some pictures. He has also to buy all the rights, because when he will give us the pictures, we will publish it as open data. So the one who creates the picture at the beginning of the chain has to provide the rights that everybody in the chain can publish this data as open data, which is not a technical issue. It's a very complicated issue of informing a lot of different stakeholders about what open data is and how you deal all this stuff of copyrights and publishing as open data content. And next, free software. We are using the reuse software project by FSFE more and more to educate the companies who work for our infrastructure so they understand what licensing means. How do I mark my source code under a certain license? And for us, this is an easier way to integrate software from third parties, because it's machine readable and it's not, I call someone to ask if I can do it. So with this overview, I hope to have given you in 10 minutes, 15 minutes, an overview about how we are in South Tyrol, together with all the companies we have here and the organizations, creating a community which has the knowledge about, if we want to be a first mover in tourism, we have to use open technologies and we have to have the knowledge about the technology. We cannot just buy a product from some country in the world and hope to be an innovative leader in this sector. If South Tyrol wants to be a leader in digital tourism, we have to create the knowledge here. We need the freedom to experiment and to create innovation in South Tyrol itself. And I think in the tourism sector, we will be able to find the answers for the challenges in the tourism and to create this infrastructure, which was very important for us.